Next question. These are serious questions. Are you pressured by your family to act in a certain way?
No, balahura ako.
No?
No, I think they know how I am. Like, I'm not ashamed. I think nobody knows that, but you know how I am when I'm in parties. You know, I'm so, so shy. Yeah. I'm so... I would say I'm the life of the party.
Okay.
No, they know how I am.
In my case, because I feel like we were brought up in such a very typical East Asian way, where, you know, parents compare kids to other kids. So we were always, it was always the feeling like you had to be like on par with your, or like match their level. If you can't go on top, then at least match the level. So that's why I was very clean cut growing up. Like, I didn't really have a very rebellious stage or anything.
Yeah.
Not until I turned 30 and I lived in Japan. You know, vomiting in the streets of Shibuya. Clubbing every Saturday.
So you were aging backwards.
I guess so. If you could have a different number of siblings, what would it be?
Different number of siblings?
Yeah.
We were supposed to have, fun fact, or it's not fun, but sad fact. the things I come up with, you know. Well, sad fact. In character. Sad fact. It was...
Something came out.
I was supposed to be the fourth child.
Really?
Yeah, because there was a third one, but then she got a miscarriage. But if that third baby was a boy, I wouldn't be here right now.
Ah, they would have stopped already.
Yeah, so they were just waiting for a boy. So I think it would have been fun if we had a brother. And then, of course, continue, because I want to exist.
You want to live?
Yeah, I want to live, and also, of course, Carla also. Oh, so it would have been fun if there's five of us.
That's a lot. Five is a lot.
It's already a lot now.
Yeah, I was going to say, even four is a lot now.
Imagine having a boy. How about you?
Yeah, we're the same. I have three older sisters, and then they were just waiting on a boy. That's why my sisters have two-year gaps. Because my parents were planning it. So they had the first daughter, and then 2 years later they tried another one, and then it still wasn't a boy, so they tried another one, still wasn't a boy, and then probably kind of like gave up after the third.
Yeah.
And then like 9 years later, I don't know, somebody probably got drunk or something. Here I am.
Yes, maybe.
Yeah.
So you're a miracle baby. Are you?
I guess so, because my mom was already in her late 30s when she had me. It's still probably not as late, right? Like, what's the last, like 45, mid 40s?
Yeah, I think after 40s is a miracle baby, right?
So I'm not a miracle?
Yeah, you're just a regular. You're not special. So kind of a miracle, but not really.
Not really, yeah.
Almost a miracle.
Almost Benjamin?
Almost Benjamin. You're everything almost. Oh,
it's okay. What was the question? Siblings. We were talking about siblings.
Oh.
My sisters know this. I would have wanted a brother. Doesn't matter if he's older or younger, but I wanted to have a brother.
Yeah,
I wanted. Because I was the youngest, so I was like the butt of all jokes. Yeah. So I kind of wanted to have like another guy to, like, you know. It's your turn. But I was never spoiled, though. A lot of people think that I'm spoiled because I'm the youngest and the only boy, but I was never spoiled.
Yeah, it's obvious naman, not spoiled.
Do your parents let you stay out late?
No. I have a funny story. In 2015, when Joe and I broke up, so that was my rebellious stage.
Yeah,
so that was when I was hanging out with a lot of people. And then I would always be out until like maybe 4 a.m.
Yeah.
Like 5 a.m. I think mama got mad. I said it's like every day. So she would always call me at like 11 or 12, right? After a while... she got tired. She got tired of calling and getting mad. So one time I came home at 4 a.m. and then she was waiting at the living room.
Yeah.
With the lights off and the TV on. And she said, come here.
Oh,
shit.
Yeah.
Said, what's happening with you? You know, are you rebelling? What's happening?
Yeah.
And so I said, no, I'm just hanging out with friends. I'm working and stressed and everything. So I'm going through stuff and I just want to hang out with friends after work. And sabi niya, are you working at some place? She didn't want to tell me, ask me straight.
Yeah.
So if you're thinking, coming home at like 4 a.m., she's thinking I'm working. Are you? So I think she's implying that I'm working at a strip club.
Yeah. Oh, shit.
I come home at 4 a.m. I'm like, no, I'm just hanging out with friends. So she was like, are you sure you don't have other jobs? The bold.
She said that?
Yeah, I know, bold. And then I said, you think people are going to watch? they don't really bother you, no?
My mom didn't have a choice. But I would message her to say that I was coming home late. But she would never say, message like, come home or whatever. Mm. Or ask me where I was at.
So you were a free child.
I guess so. Mm. Okay. This is related. Do your parents trust you? And that's the last one.
Yeah, I think she does naman now. Mm. She lets me do whatever now. Because I think she knows that I can do it. And I'll always make it. How about you? Do they trust you?
As I said, I was a very good kid, so they trust me. Like, they would, like, in high school, they would allow me to go on overnight trips and stuff with friends. Mm. And, like, as long as I tell them who I was with, and then they were comfortable with that person, then everything was okay. Because remember you used my name?
Me?
Yeah. Or was it your sister? Someone messaged me one time and said, if mama calls you, tell her I'm with you, because I told her we're together, but I was just at home sleeping.
I feel like that's both of us.
I think so too.
I think we both used you.
But see, then I'm very trustworthy.
Yeah, so that's why we use you. So,
so while you guys are enjoying having fun in my name, I'm at home sleeping alone, lonely.
Oh, what's your message to your mother?
You're gonna go first.
Me? For my mother. Wish you all the best. Happy birthday. Birthday greeting. Birthday greeting. God bless. Not message na lang. Aran na lang. Like one thing you appreciate about her.
Towards me specifically, patience. I appreciate her patience towards me.
Yeah.
Because I do whatever I want. I always did. And so she's been very patient. Like, she didn't want me to come to Japan at all. Mm. She said, if you were going to leave, go to your sister or go to somewhere where there's another family member.
Yeah.
So she's always worried. Against Japan. Yeah. Mm. There was the trust, but then she was worried that, you know, things might happen.
Yeah.
So what do you appreciate the most from your mother?
I think there's two kinds of mothers, no? One who's very career focused and the other is very family focused. More on like being a mother, taking care of the kids and everything. I feel like mama is that kind of mother. Like, she's willing to sacrifice anything for us. So what I appreciate the most about her, pwede ba mangopya? Pwede lang patience. I think patience and having that sense of humor. And she's so naive.
Yeah.
So every time I bully her, you know, she believes right away. So when we joke around with her, she falls for it, and then, you know, after that she laughs about it.
Yeah.
So I think that's what I appreciate the most. Kasi that's the highlight of our gatherings. It's weird kasi before my mom would call me and I wouldn't answer kasi I would just get in trouble. Where are you at? You're not home. What are you doing? Now I call her. Now I call her, and then when she doesn't answer, I tell Joe, like, what the heck, how come she's not answering? So weird. And then it's through FaceTime. And then we would just talk like we're friends, you know, which is really fun. Which is funny.
Wow. I want to add that, you know, I grew up with three sisters. So, and because of the gap, they were much more mature than me growing up.
Yeah.
So they were more than being sisters. They were a lot like mothers to me also, even until now. So I grew up with four mothers.
But I love Papa also.
But this is not a Father's Day episode.
So next month, I love him also. But this month, it's Mama first. Since you said you grew up with four mothers, so you had three siblings from mas matanda.
Yeah.
I think you found the three siblings who are your age through us, right?
I guess that's why a lot of my friends are younger than me.
Yeah.
I actually don't have a lot of friends that are the same age as me. Aside from Gino and Brian, most of my friends are younger than me.
Really? For me, I get along with people who are older. Maybe that's why we're friends.
That's why we're friends.
You know, her name on my phone is Mother. Just Mother. Walang pangalan or whatever, just Mother. And then my papa is Father. Father.
And then the last name is Father. Mr. and Mrs. is Father, Mother, Father.
So we're a family of Fathers.